Hello everyone, my name is Mr. Hurricane. Welcome back to the Jacksonville Jaguars franchise. The Jaguars play their second AFC South matchup today, with their first meeting with the Houston Texans. The 1-4 Jaguars take on the 2-3 Texans, as the Jaguars are riding a 3-game losing streak. These games have been ugly. They first lost 52-3 to New England, 45-6 to Indianapolis, and last week, 42-25 to Tampa Bay. There's a lot of work to do, especially on defense. Can the Jaguars get a victory back at home today against the Texans? We are underway with Marquise Lee on the return. Across the 20, here comes the offense. After two straight games without a touchdown, the offense looked much better last week. Will they put together another good performance here against Houston? On the ground, Bortles hands off to TJ Yeldon, who runs straight ahead and picks up a big 12-yard carry. In the pistol, two receivers left. Bortles back to pass on second down, and he completes to the outside to Allen Hurns. He is the man who ended the touchdown drought last week. Already in Texan territory. Handoff incoming. Here's a counter for TJ Yeldon. Bounces off a tackle and picks up seven more. Good job moving the ball on this initial possession. Now off the fake, receivers going deep, and Bortles scrambles outside the pocket, picks up the first down, but a flag is on the field. And it looks like this one's coming back. Holding on Zane Beatles will wipe out that Blake Bortles run. It hasn't been a very good stretch of games for Zane Beatles. Jaguars backed up to second and long. How will they respond? Pass is caught by Aurelius Ben inside the 45, setting up a third down and seven. Julius Thomas in the slot. Here comes the blitz. Pass goes up the seam to Aurelius Ben, giving the Jaguars a first down on the gain of 20. Aurelius Ben coming up big. Now a red zone trip on the first drive. There's pressure. Bortles off his back foot. Gets the ball downfield to Julius Thomas. And that's good for seven. 5 of 5 for Blake Bortles. Very impressive. Hand out for TJ Yeldon running left. Gets past one and a gain of 6. Receiver stacked right on third down and 4. Bortles from the shotgun. Under pressure. His pass is caught by Aurelius Ben, but shy of the marker. It appeared he had a man open in the end zone, and the Jaguars' offense is staying on the field. Fourth down and 1. Yeldon gets it, and the Texans make the stop. The Jaguars march down the field and turn it over on downs. Second-year lineman Anthony Johnson beat the center Wisniewski, and the Texans take over at their own 4. The quarterback is Brian Hoyer. I formation give to Arian Foster. Breaking away from Skuda, still won't go down. Some messy tackling and a first down. DeAndre Hopkins in motion. We have to keep our eye on him. On first down, pass goes to DeAndre Hopkins on the drag, and he picks up 7. Hopkins still without a touchdown this season, by the way. Second down, Hoyer complete again short. Now it's Deron Carter, and the sloppy tackling shows up again. That needs to be cleaned up. Second down, hands off, a stretch for Arian Foster, gets a block on the edge by Strong, and the tackle is made by Sergio Brown after the first down is picked up. Alfred Blue checks in the game. They run a counter, follows his guard, now gets in front, and we're probably lucky he did, likely cost him some yardage. Second and inches, and the Texans want to take a shot. Hoyer goes deep as he's hit, double coverage against Hopkins, and it's knocked away by Cyprian. Good defense downfield, but now third and inches. They'll throw forward again. Nobody open. Hoyer in trouble. Scrambling, now firing across the field. And the pass is ripped away from Carter by Dwayne Gratz. Gratz and Devon House have swapped sides this week. And Gratz continues to play like the Jaguars' best corner. No score here in the first quarter. Jaguars take over. And TJ Yeldon gets loose for about 10 yards. First down. Much better start to the ground game this week. First down for the Jaguars. Pass goes outside to Thomas. Here goes the speed. In Texan territory. Cut from behind at the 35-yard line. We're looking for more of those big plays from Thomas. He got 35 yards after the catch. New set of downs again. Swing pass for TJ Yeldon. And that's good for about 5 yards on first down. Third down and 3. Two tight ends in the game. Jaguars throw for it. And Bortles almost throws a pick. That one clearly got away from him. And luckily the Jaguars keep possession to kick the field goal. Jason Myers kicks it up and through. The Jaguars lead in the second quarter. Have not been able to say that in a while. Texans take over after their first possession failed, and now Arian Foster carries for a good gain. This team cannot tackle this week. What is going on? They are not appearing very focused against the run. Second down from the 46-yard line. Hoyer down the field, flagged down as the pass is incomplete for Hopkins, and they're going to get Dwayne Gratz, who had pretty obvious downfield contact. Gratz needs to make the smarter play there. Texans now have it at the Jaguar 37. Fake to Foster, there's pressure. Lob downfield, should have been picked! Stonehand Cyprian drops it! Jaguars go single high safety, it's 3rd and 5. They try to bring pressure, it's picked up, and Hopkins makes the catch inside the 20. Now the Texans are into the red zone. Two receivers right, they run left. And Foster put the ball on the ground! Recovered by Devon House! The Jaguars get a big turnover! And it's Jared Odrick's biggest play as a Jaguar! Good to see him making an impact! The Jaguars team still has not allowed points today. Up 3-0, back on offense, and Bortles is thrown to the ground by Vince Wilfork. Incomplete. Marquise Lee lines up in the slot, Jags need 8. Good protection. Bortles downfield to Allen Hurns. Well-timed throw by Blake Bortles. We'll see this one more time. Bortles has made some great downfield passes this season. That's what happens when he gets time in the pocket. At the 43-yard line, 9:40 to go in the half, and T.J. Yeldon gives the Jaguars another first down. They're nearing midfield. Aurelius Ben checks in the game. Texans blitz, and Bortles throws a pass in the dirt in front of Allen Hurns. These short throws over the middle are giving Bortles some trouble. 3rd and 11, Thomas motions into the slot. And Bortles does not like his looks downfield, and he's sacked by Darnell Dockett. And the Texans get a stop. Midway through the second and only 3 points combined. Plenty of time for Hoyer, who throws up high to Jalen Strong. House couldn't knock it away, and Strong gets a big first down. After the gain of 20, play fake, inside pressure, Hoyer scrambling and hitting Garrett Graham! In Jaguar territory, he runs out of bounds. He got away from Dwayne Gratz after Hoyer got away from Jared Odrick. Tight ends continue to give this defense problems. Now off the fake, Hoyer going up top for Hopkins, and he makes the catch! Are you kidding me? It's ruled incomplete! I thought this was a touchdown, but look at this! He rolls off of Gratz, and that left foot hits the chuck. What a break for Jacksonville. It forces second down. Hoyer facing some trouble. He is sacked by Sendarek Marks. It's his first sack on the season. It comes at a great time, knocking the Texans into deep field goal range. Now can the defense get a play on 3rd and 17? Defense rushes 4. Clean pocket for Brian Hoyer. He checks it down to Arian Foster. Gets inside the 30. And that's manageable field goal distance. I have to say the defense has really stepped up their play this week. They've gotten a big turnover and have only allowed 3 points. 4:36 to go in the first half in this defensively focused matchup. T.J. Yeldon in some trouble outside, but he gets away and he's across the 35. Turns that into a gain of 6. Offset eye on 3rd down, play fake for Bortles, and there's J.J. Watt delivering the hit, and Bortles throws incomplete. We could only keep him quiet for so long. We've ran away from him, and now he's getting some pass rush going. Texans have it with less than 3 minutes to go in the half, and Jared Odrick with another good stop on Arian Foster, this becoming quickly his best game of the year. 3rd down and 5 for Hoyer, and he's got a man open on the outside. We fail to cover Garrett Graham again. 1st down. 2 minutes to go in the half at the 49 of Jacksonville. Man coverage downfield, and they let Garrett Graham get open again. He beats Telvin Smith, and Graham picks up 38. I'm certain no team allows more yards to tight ends. 2nd down and 10. Hoyer going to the end zone for Jalen Strong, and he's ruled out of bounds. Dwayne Gratz on the coverage, and this is going to be reviewed. Jalen Strong, did he get both feet down? It looks like that one just hits the chalk. And now for the ruling, and they overturned it! It's a touchdown for Houston! I cannot believe the referees overturned that call. It's 10-3 Houston, with 48 seconds to go in the half. Deep over the middle, Blake Bortles connects with Julius Thomas. Those are the plays we've been waiting for. The offense has plenty of time for an answer. Second down and 10. Bortles downfield to Rashad Green. Inside the 15, he steps out of bounds. The Jaguars quickly marching down the field. 35 seconds left. Bortles under pressure, and he's sacked again by Darnell Dockett. This defensive line is starting to get a lot of rush. Second down and 16, now a blitz is brought. Bortles to the sideline, and Julius Thomas makes the grab. 15-yard connection. It's been a strong first half for Thomas. Now the Jaguars go empty on third down. Bortles under pressure, and Thomas drops a first down. Bortles with J.J. Watt in his face. And Julius Thomas picked the worst time for a drop. The Texans are still leading by four as we've reached halftime, but the Jaguars do appear to be much improved here in week six. The defense has only allowed 10 points, and the touchdown was a controversial one. The offense has moved the ball, but they're still making mistakes and only have 6 points to show for it. Texan ball to begin the third quarter. Brian Hoyer hands off to Arian Foster, who got going early, picks up a good gain on first down. Second down and 3, 22 personnel, they run again. Big block on the outside by C.J. Fedorowicz, springs Foster for a gain of 15. Fedorowicz actually had 2 blocks on that play. Now the Texans go empty and the pass goes to Alfred Blue from the slot. And he has a first down and appears to be shaken up. Arian Foster checks back into the game. 3-wide set. Foster gets it, and he meets Telvin Smith. Only a gain of 1. Second down and 9, now a tight formation. Hoyer from the pocket, plenty of time. Short pass hauled in by DeAndre Hopkins gives the Texans a first down inside the 35. Pretty efficient day for Brian Hoyer. He's back to pass again, and the hit delivered by Telvin Smith forces an incompletion. Cyprian down in the box on 3rd and 2. Texans keep it on the ground, and Arian Foster picks up the first down. A gain of 9. Texans again in the red zone. Hand off for Arian Foster. He's got a lane, makes a move inside the 10, and breaks a tackle as he makes his way down to the 5. Nearly a 5-minute possession. Hoyer back to pass. Up top for Strong, and good defense by Devon House. We'll see if he continues to play better on that side. Hoyer turns, hands off to Chris Polk on 2nd and goal, and there's no gain thanks to Dan Scuda. Jaguars trying to hold tough again in the red zone. Hoyer throws, and that's a touchdown for Jalen Strong. That is his 7th touchdown of the season, his 2nd today, and that was a huge mismatch against Telvin Smith. The Texans have put together 2 straight touchdown possessions, and now the Jaguars will attempt to answer. Marquise Lee on the return across the 25. Flag down. This is going to be holding on Jacksonville, so they'll start inside their own 15. Tight formation on 2nd down. Bortles back to pass. Rush there again, but he passes in time to Julius Thomas. He makes up for his holding call, has not made up for his drop yet. Bortles back to pass on 2nd down and throws on target to a receiver on a slant this time. Caught by Allen Hurns. High formation as the Jaguars run on 3rd and 2. They go weak side, and T.J. Yeldon is stopped for a loss. They ran away from J.J. Watt, still gets stopped. Houston beginning to take control as Hoyer has his pass knocked away by Telvin Smith. Now in a 3-wide shotgun, Hoyer takes the snap on 2nd down. Plenty of time in the pocket, and his pass is hauled in by Garrett Graham. Sergio Brown had good position, but he couldn't make a play. Another play given up to a tight end. Now the receiver screen set up for Jalen Strong, and he gets about 9 yards. Fedorowicz in the game on 3rd and inches, and Hoyer gives to Foster, who sweeps off tackle and picks up the first down. He runs inside the Jaguar 40. 2:50 to play in the third quarter. Over the middle, complete to Deron Carter. That's another gain of 7. Brian Hoyer has definitely found his rhythm. New set of downs. Hoyer, touch pass down the middle for DeAndre Hopkins. The Texans get 1st and goal on the gain of 20. Hopkins, the lone receiver, 1st and goal. Hoyer passes. That's caught by Garrett Graham for a touchdown. He beat Dwayne Gratz. Perhaps the Jaguars double covered the wrong guy on that snap. They had 2 guys on Hopkins, and Garrett Graham takes advantage of his one-on-one. 24-6. The Texans have scored 3 straight touchdowns, and Marquise Lee just let his momentum take him out at the 5-yard line. Things again appear to be getting out of control for Jacksonville as TJ Yeldon gives them a spark on the ground with that gain of 11. Yeldon has ran the ball fairly efficiently today. Now off the fake, Bortles can't roll out, but he can pass downfield to Julius Thomas, and that's a gain of 10. Jaguars need to start picking out the pace, down by 18, nearing the fourth quarter. Pass hauled in by Allen Robinson, his first catch of the game. A surprisingly quiet day for Robinson to this point. First and 10, now plenty of time for Bortles, and Allen Hurns drops it. No excuse for that drop. 14:37 to play in the game, it's third down, and Bortles is picked off by Quinton Demps. This time it's Bortles with the mistake as he was off target for Marquise Lee. Bortles has thrown the ball well today, but clearly his worst pass came right there. Sixth interception of the season. Texans take over. Their offense has been red hot since the end of the first half, and there's a good carry for Chris Polk. Polk in the backfield again, fake. Hoyer looking deep down the field, and the pocket collapses around him. He is sacked by Chris Clemens. Defense in a favorable spot now, forcing a 3rd and 16. Hoyer off the fake just dumps it off to Jalen Strong, and the Jaguars have forced a 3-and-out. Jaguars take over with just under 11 minutes to go, and they trail by 18. Bortles steps up and looks to take off. He picks up the first down and slides. Gain of 13. Marquise Lee in the slot. Fake to TJ Yeldon. Bortles outside for Thomas, who was interfered with. Clear flag there on Quinton Demps. Now at the 37-yard line, Thomas in the slot. Bortles over the middle to TJ Yeldon, and that's a first down to the 48-yard line. Thomas now split outside to the right. 2nd and 3. Jaguars pick up the rush, and the pass goes downfield to Thomas. He lost the football, recovers it. Julius Thomas fumbled and lost one last week. He almost lost another. But Thomas has gotten a lot of production in this game. Jaguars back in the red zone. 9 minutes left, 4 receivers on the field. Bortles under pressure. He throws a pick. In the end zone, Raheem Moore snatches it, as Bortles thought he had a man in the back of the end zone. But there was Moore waiting underneath. Texans facing a 3rd and 10 from the 3. Handoff for Foster. He is met near the goal line, and they'll say he's down at the 1. Foster also hurt on the play. Demetrius McCray made the tackle, and you can see the nose of the football break free from the goal line. 8.5 minutes left. Jaguars get it back, and TJ Yeldon will get them a good carry as he muscles his way to midfield. Denard Robinson now in the game, and a little over 7 minutes to go. Bortles to the sideline. Thomas is there for another reception. Out of bounds at the 32. On 2nd down, 4-man rush. Bortles outside to Marquise Lee, who couldn't handle it. Another drop. Hurns in the slot, 3rd down and 10. Bortles with time. He lobs it for Hurns, and he goes to the ground to make the catch. Well done by Allen Hurns. Now just over 6 minutes left, 2 tight ends in the game. 7-step drop. Bortles steps up, fires end zone, touchdown Aurelius Ben. Finally, the Jaguars get something going in the red zone. That's their first touchdown on the day, but it wasn't their first opportunity. 24-12, now trying to make it a 10-point game. Bortles, end zone for Thomas, and he makes a great catch to make it a 10-point game. This one's still definitely not over. 6 minutes to play, and Foster is stopped on first down by Telvin Smith. The defense has picked up their play in the fourth quarter. Foster again. Smith there on the stop to force 3rd down and 4. Now can they force their 3rd straight stop? 3rd and 4. Fake to Foster. Hoyer has all day, and a man open. It's a tight end. CJ Fedorowicz with the 1st down. Another 3rd down for the Texans. Now they call the screen. Hoyer out to Foster, and it's well defended by Jonathan Cyprien. The Texans took a lot of time off the clock before they got stopped. 2.5 to go. Good coverage downfield, and Bortles lost the football. Still on the ground and picked up by Houston. J.J. Watt forces the fumble. Great man coverage downfield, and the Jaguars may have just lost their chance to make a game out of this. From the 1-yard line, Arian Foster into the end zone to make it a 3-score contest once again. This Jaguar team definitely never gives up. but they don't execute well enough late in the game. Blake Bortles now just off the mark. Things aren't going well for this squad. They've turned it over three out of their last four drives, and now Bortles is sacked by Vince Wilfork. They've gotten a lot of pressure in this second half. Third and 16. Bortles to Allen Robinson, who breaks away from Kareem Jackson, sprinting in Texan territory, and he takes this inside the 20 and is finally caught at the 7-yard line. That's a 77-yard play for Robinson. Now looking for another touchdown, Bortles on first and goal, rushes there, and Darnell Dockett gets his third sack on the day. Backed up to the 14, second down and goal. Interior rush again, and the ball is knocked out. Recovered by Wisniewski. Not in a good spot now on third and goal from the 24. Bortles steps up, lobs for Allen Hurns, and the pass is tipped off his hands and incomplete. Jason Myers is out to make this a two-score game, and his 41-yard try sails up and through. Now the Jaguars need an onside kick recovery, a score, and that same sequence again. Here's the kick by Brian Anger, and the Texans fall on it. And Houston will come away with the victory, handing the Jaguars their fourth straight loss. 31-17 here in Week 6. The last 3 weeks, we've been hard on the defense, who stepped up this week. Yes, they allowed 31 points. Seven of those came after that Bortles fumble inside the five. They were improved. The offense, however, made too many mistakes. You don't win games when you turn the ball over twice in the red zone. We did so on downs on the first possession of the game, and then there was the Raheem Moore interception. That first drive, I thought we were playing well enough to pick up that fourth and one, but I call the bad play. They had the box stacked, prepared for the run. I didn't have a tight end on that side. Elected to go with the fullback instead. Should have just gotten 22. Tight end on either side, plus a fullback, we probably convert. The interception to Raheem Moore was just a bad read. Didn't see the underneath coverage. That was well played. There was the Quinton Demps interception before that, and that was just a bad throw by Blake Bortles. We also had issues with drops. Wide open, Allen Hurns had a drop. Julius Thomas inside the five had one before halftime. And the offensive line did not do a good job. J.J. Watt was just the least of our issues, with Darnell Dockett racking up four sacks. Zane Beatles will not start next week. The rookie third-rounder A.J. Cann will get his shot at left guard. And he's up against the very good Buffalo Bill front four next week. The Bills are without Tyrod Taylor. We'll see them start E.J. Manuel, as both teams travel across the pond and will play this game in London, 9:30 a.m. We'll see if that can snap the four-game losing streak for Jacksonville. And as promised, here is your first prospect preview for the Jacksonville Jaguars franchise. This week, middle linebacker is the focus. My favorite so far on the board is third-round prospect Antoine Young from Florida. 6'1", 238, not a big middle linebacker, but he has run-stopping capabilities. His best three traits: tackling, pursuit, and hit power. I don't know yet about his coverage ability, but if he has those skills, I would compare him to Vikings rookie Eric Kendricks, who has a very similar physical build. Our current middle linebacker is Paul Posluszny, who has played well against the run this season. He's getting up there in age, 30 years old, and he's not much of a cover guy. I play him mainly as a two-down linebacker, but I don't have three-down linebackers I really trust on this roster. Posluszny still has two seasons beyond this one under contract. Linebacker is one of the biggest focuses of my scouting so far, and I'd like to know what you guys would like to see me preview next week. Let me know down in the comment section which position I should preview a player for. Thank you all for watching today's video as the Jaguars fall to 1-5. We'll see if they can get back on track as they take on the Buffalo Bills in London. Please leave a like if you enjoyed the video. Comment below your thoughts on today's game. Which players impressed you? What did you think of the prospect and what I should preview next week? And subscribe if you have not done so already. Much more to come here in the Jaguars franchise. Have a great day, guys. I'll see you in London.